Good evening, everyone. Joe for Jaspy's Hobbyland here. We are doing a full case break of 2016 Topps Gold Label Baseball. This is Pick Your Team number 7 from jaspyshobbyland.com. A big thank you to these folks right here for getting into the action. John Parker with the Indians, Last Spot Mojo. The Indians and the Cubs, so the World Series teams, were the last two teams that were sold. So World Series Mojo is a possibility. Full case break. Glad we're able to do this baseball because I think it offers a nice bit of offers a nice kind of palate cleanser for all that immaculate football we've been doing. Oh, the camera's acting weird. Hang on, so let me pause the video. We're gonna come back and fix that camera. All right, welcome back, folks. I think we I think our camera issues are set right here now. We shouldn't be jumpy anymore. So here's the case. Like I said, we're doing all 16 boxes. So let's pop this open. Yeah, our video should be a lot better now. All right, empty box. All right. So you can see the stacks of four right here. Start right here. So in case you're wondering, here's what it looks like. There's one framed autograph card per box, gold label, etc., etc. There's a bunch of base cards and variations, all sorts of things. So good luck, everybody. Here we go. Looks like some baseball news happening that Brandon Parrott, this is the frame, let me save this right over here. Brandon Parrott telling us some baseball news, which is appropriate for this baseball break. Brian McCann and Josh Reddick all going to the Astros. So yeah, Shahade saying, looks like the Astros mean business. All right, so quick look right here. We're gonna have to go a little bit faster than this, but I just wanna show you where the class number is. So that's a class one. And then I'll show you some other examples too. So this is class two. So there's different short prints, you know? And then there'll be numbered ones as well. Here's a class three, Yoenis Cespedes. You can see on the bottom right-hand corner in the background, you see the text right there. These blue parallels, there's classes 1, 2, and 3 for the blue parallels as well. I'm not going to stop at every one of those cards, but just letting you know that that's what they look like and that's what to kind of look out for. So there's nice Chris Bryant right there. And there's some of these will be numbered. I don't see any. Oh, there it is. There's a numbered one. So this is a class one, Andrew McCutchen, number 37 out of 100. So there could be a class two and class three, and there'll be different numbering systems as well. Pirates, that goes to John Parker. There you go. Nice. All card ship, Martin. All card ship. All right, and the framed auto. All right, we got a class one Ichiro. We got Craig Kimbrel. And 6 out of 50, Carl Edwards Jr. Nice framed autograph. That is strong. So right on the card, I like the frame auto at 6 out of 50. Cubs, Derek Slavik with the Cubs. Picked up the Cubs late. getting a little bit of that World Series mojo. Nice. Next box. So each box has a framed autograph. So since we're doing a 16 box break, obviously 16 framed autographs. Is it jersey number? I'm not sure. What is it? What is his jersey? Is he number 6? Or is he number 50? And Cubs fans, let me know. This is the frame auto. I'm going to save that. All right, Kyle's saying, yeah, number 6. There you go. Jersey number, Cubs. There you go, Derek. All right, there's Freddie Freeman. And, nice, more Cubs. Andre Dawson, 81 out of 100, the Hawk, going to the Cubs. That's a class 1 out of 100. So like I said, I'm going to be moving through these a little bit more quickly now, just in the interest of time. But everything ships, so you'll be getting all of this stuff. There's Blue Parallels, that was a class 2. Sandy Koufax, that's just a class 1. Ichiro, class 1. And the frame. Gold frame, there's Kyle Schwarber. There's the chip off the old block, and for the Dodgers, Frankie Montas, gold frame autograph. That card is gold! Dodgers going to Kev, California. Although I'm pretty sure he got traded to the Mariners, I think, but this is Dodgers edition, Frankie Montas. Nice. Next box, good luck. This is the frame. Trey Turner. Some blue parallels there. Yu Darvish. David Ortiz. Trying to keep an eye out for class 3. Manny Machado, that's a blue parallel, class 1. Class 2, right there, so those are your base cards. And the hit, another gold frame, sort of a dent in there if you look right there. I was like, what is that? So just keep that in mind. All right, we've got Jose Bautista, class 1. Roberto Clemente, class 1, and looks like a Philly. That's Mikhail Franco. Nice. Gold frame auto, Mikhail Franco for the Fightin' Phils. Who has the Phillies? TJ with the Phillies. Nice. Part of that young Phillies crew. A lot of youngsters on the Phillies, a lot of youngsters on the Braves. The NL East could be interesting in the future, in the near future. This is the frame. Next box, good luck. Stan Musial. There's Sandy Koufax, class one. There's your MVP right there, Mike Trout. 89 out of 100. Nice Mike Trout. That's a class one. 89 out of 100. Your AL MVP for this season. He could have won the AL MVP, I think, all five of his years in the majors, if not for like someone winning triple crowns and stuff like that. There's Julio Urias, class one, Kershaw. All these are upside down, right side up. There's Hunter Pence. Mookie Betts, almost MVP. He got some votes. Blue parallel and Carlos Correa. And the frame. Another gold frame. That's Miguel Sano. That's Willie Mays. And the auto is Carlos Martinez for the Cardinals. John Parker with the Redbirds. Nice one, John. The next one. That's the frame auto. We'll do that last. Good luck. All right, we've got some Carlos Correa, some Byung-ho Park, or I guess Bak Byung-ho in Korean. 02, 002 out of 100. Nice one for the Twins. Goes to Jimmy Brandt and the Twins. Like that's a class three, Chris Sale. Nice. That's a shorter print. I think it's like one out of every 20 packs or something like that. And a numbered Kershaw card. Nice. Class two. So class two out of 50. Nice one for the Dodgers. That goes to Kev California. It's the blue parallel, as you can tell right there. Another blue one, and then there's Ken Griffey Jr., class two. And your frame. There's Giancarlo Stanton, The Big Hurt, Frank Thomas. And for the A's, Sean Doolittle. Gold frame autograph. Nice one for the Oakland A's. Who's got the A's? John Parker with the A's. So what other baseball news is going on, ladies and gentlemen? So Brandon was telling me about the Astros making their moves. There's the frame right there. Astros making their moves. What are the other moves or rumors or what is going on? I haven't looked at MLBTradeRumors.com is one of my favorite sites for hot stove stuff, but I've not really looked at that over the last couple days. Is there anything else going on? Any other transactions of note? Or any rumors of note? Let me know, folks. All right, Granky. It's Kyle Schwarber. And nice Aroldis Chapman. 4 out of 50. Class 2 Aroldis Chapman. Nice. Yankees, that'll go to John Parker with the Yanks. Yeah, are there Verlander to the Dodgers rumors? That's interesting. Tigers are looking to move some contract, so that could be an interesting move for the Dodgers. Gerrit Cole, 22 out of 25. That's a Class 3. Numbered card right here. 22 out of 25. Nice one for the Pirates. That's for John Parker. So what's the rumor? Like, who would the Dodgers have to move to get Justin Verlander? I suppose I'd have to look at how many years Verlander has left and all that jazz. Could be an interesting move, though. All right, your frame auto, there's Gerrit Cole. There is Ryan Braun. And your autograph is Cole Calhoun. Gold frame autograph. Nice. So that'll go to the Angels. Who has the Angels? Kev California, who has both Southern California teams, or both LA area teams, that is. This one's in Orange County. But... prospects. I'm assuming the big names, TJ. I'm assuming Julio Urias is in the conversation. Dodgers were to get Verlander, De Leon's probably in the mix. The top five were on the list. That makes sense. An interesting move, although my gut feeling is that I think to me, after thinking about it after the playoffs, I felt like the offense was a little bit more of a concern. Cold bats were more of a concern than more than our pitching, you know. But I wouldn't turn down a Justin Verlander in the rotation. Jose Abreu, 49 out of 100, Class 1 out of 100 for the White Sox. That'll go to John Parker. And the frame. And Jose Peraza for the Reds. Nice Reds autograph. That goes out to Aaron. Aaron with the red legs. With the speedster, Jose Peraza. All right, talk to me, folks. Like, who has, what are your favorite teams? Who's the teams that you support? Tell me that, first of all. And then let me know what's going on, like what their off-season plans are. Sup, Chris? Chris Cabral? Some solid hits. Nothing monstrous yet. Bowman, what's going on? For my Dodgers, you know, I think we've shown that we are able to even through adversity, with like Kershaw being injured, or, you know, so many rotational guys. I think we've shown that we can compete over the regular season with the depth that we have. But I think the Dodgers need to start thinking more about, you know, the playoffs, obviously, and going deep into the playoffs. Just getting there is just not enough anymore. It's Corey Seager, your Rookie of the Year. Mike Trout, your MVP. It's a Class 3. It's Mike Trout again. That's a Class 1. So you can see that the pictures are already different for the between Class 1 and 3. Chris Cabral is saying, I'm interested in who the White Sox end up trading Chris Sale to. Yeah, a lot of teams do. He has a very friendly contract, Chris Sale. And White Sox, if they're smart, they may be able to pull a ton of great prospects for Chris Sale. All right, there's your almost MVP, Mookie Betts. There's the Dark Knight, Matt Harvey. And we got a Mariner, Ketel Marte. Gold ink. Or gold frame autograph, blue ink. Mariners going out to Adam Fairbank. Did I pass a numbered red card? Come on, Joe. I don't think so. Sometimes it's confusing because the background right here will be like a red background, like red seats or something like that. And so that always... Yeah, like this card always confuses me. Because they're like the Ryan Braun, because there's always like that red background there. So... All right. Next box. Aaron says, hey, I'm not really a MLB fan, but if I had to pick a team, it'd be the Twins. Twins are pretty solid. They kind of had a weird year this year, but the year before that, their young core really showed what they could be potentially capable of. That's the frame. I'll save that. Brinson saying that Mookie should have won the MVP. We were talking about that earlier. I think what I was saying anyway was that Trout put up. I know Mookie Betts maybe statistically had slightly better numbers, but I think, you know, Mike Trout putting up those numbers on a bad team with no lineup protection, I think was what gave him the gave him the MVP edge. There's Tulo. And I apologize for going somewhat quickly without being able to linger on those class numbers, but just in the interest of time, we're gonna have to do it that way. Yeah, absolutely, Brinson. Both great players. I mean, you know, poor Mike Trout. You almost expect that from him. So it's like it doesn't seem as impressive, but just because he does it so often. But Mookie Betts certainly had a very fine season. That's for sure. The Red Sox is going to be scary for a number of years. There's MVP Chris Bryant, and we got George Springer gold frame autograph. Nice George Springer, and that will be for the Astros. That's for Brandon Parrott. There you go, Brandon. Some Astros coming your way. Now, we are pretty close to wrapping up this break, ladies and gentlemen, so my suggestion to you is, especially if you're not in this particular break, is to go to jaspyshobbyland.com right now and start grabbing your teams in Immaculate Football. We have a full case break of Immaculate Football that we're trying to move, and that's pretty close to single digits. I think we can get it there before this break is over. There we go. Speaking of Chris Sale, there he is. 3 out of 50. Class 2, Chris Sale. Will the White Sox move him? If they do, who do they get? When does the high tech get put into the... You know, I'm not sure, Chris Cabral, when high tech's going to get put into the store. Comes out Wednesday, right? Comes out Wednesday. Checklist is already out. Probably Monday. Monday or Tuesday. All right, Mark McGwire, Nolan Ryan, and Rob Refsnyder, Yankees, gold frame auto, going to John Parker. Brinson says he'll be on the Braves, Chris Sale. Bibby for three, also thinking Braves. Braves do have the prospects that they can move. They've got a ton. I mean, what names are we thinking? You know what I mean? Right, they got the new stadium too. They definitely want to make a big splash. Yeah, Braves aren't afraid of spending money, but they finally deconstructed their team, and now they're reconstructing their team. They got a new stadium. You know, I think they're, you know, they got good young players coming up, and they can afford to trade away some young players. There's the frame. You know, to chase someone like Chris Sale. But who would they have to move? What are the rumors saying? I've heard the rumor too. Chris Sale to the Braves, because they have the pieces. But Cabral saying, I don't think the Braves have the quote elite prospects to get Sale. True, and they're probably not going to move Swanson. But I wonder if the White Sox would be like, hey, maybe we'll take a bigger package just for the depth. All right. There's Carlos Gonzalez. There's 38 out of 50, Max Scherzer. There's your NL Cy Young Award winner. Nice one for the Nats, going to TJ. And the frame. And we got Don Mattingly, Noah Syndergaard, and Cole Calhoun. Another one, but numbered 20 out of 50. Cole Calhoun for the Angels and Kev California. Chris Cabral is saying Red Sox are said to have want Chris Sale. Wouldn't mind Moncada, Benintendi, or Devers going the other way. Dodgers, yeah, Urias or Jose De Leon would be the one that they would have to move, among others. But that'll be interesting. I mean, we looked at Chris Sale's contract the other night, Chris, I was just like, right. He got signed to a long-term deal, you know, a little while ago, but he has a lot of years left, and a lot of years left, and at a very cheap price. It's a great contract. All right, Frank Thomas. There is Adam Jones for the Orioles, Jimmy Brandt with the O's. That's 60 out of 100, class 1. We've got 10 out of 25, nice. 1 out of 20, sorry, it was upside down. 1 out of 25, class 3, Matt Kemp. San Diego Padres. That'll go to Big Boys 007. Nice. The class threes are obviously numbered lower. And Chris saying what? The deadline, they kept saying White Sox wouldn't even talk to the Red Sox unless they were getting Moncada, Devers, and Kopech in the deal. Right, and for the Dodgers, Cody Bellinger and Julio, your Urias is the starting point. If I'm the White Sox, that's where I definitely start too. David Ortiz, Trey Turner, and Jim Abbott for the Angels. There you go, Kev California with a Jim Abbott. I feel like you have a lot of these from like some different break that we did a while back. No? Maybe? Am I just making that up? Well, another Jim Abbott for you, Kevin. All right. 4 boxes to go. Solid autos, but we're looking for kind of a wow auto out of here. Decent case, solid case, but let's see if we can end on a very strong note here. Oh, you have a lot of that Dodgers guy, Frankie Montas. There's Donnie Baseball. Let's see if we can get a good focus on that. Focus camera, there we go. Like no numbered. Oh, there it is. I thought there was gonna be no numbered cards in this one. There's Cal Ripken Jr. 61 out of 100. Class 1 for the Orioles for Jimmy Brandt. And where does Justin Verlander end up? Does he go somewhere? Tigers kind of dismantling their team. Chris Cabral with some more news. Two separate sources affiliated with the two separate organizations reached out to me the information, blah, blah, blah. The Sox and Dodgers are discussing a mega deal that would send Chris Sale and Todd Frazier to the Dodgers. Needless to say, an absurd return that one would have to think that centered around Urias, Bellinger, and a lot more. Yeah, seriously. And that would mean that the Dodgers would be giving up on Justin Turner in the free agent market, which would bum me out. I like Justin Turner. And another Rob Refsnyder, gold frame autograph. There you go. It's another one for John Parker and the Yankees. Three more autos to go. Big Dog says, what, give him Yasiel? I think Dodger fans like myself often overrate Yasiel Puig and when what he can actually get on a trade market. But I think he does, yeah, I agree with Chris. I was just about to say the same thing. He does need a change of scenery. And, you know, Chicago might be a pretty good place for him. And Puig on a team-friendly contract as well. All right, there's the chip off the old block, Chipper Jones. That's Jose Bautista. There you go, Martin. 12 out of 100 on a Class 1 Jose Bautista. Yeah, see, this red background sometimes confuses me. Sorry, I kind of went out of focus right there. So there's Kyle Schwarber. That's Class 1. And the next framed autograph. So we've got a gold frame, Manny Machado up front. Yu Darvish. And another Yankee, Luis Severino, gold frame autograph. Another frame auto for the Yankees, John Parker. Two left. Good luck, everybody. Remember, this break is almost done, so if you want to get a head start on filling up the next break, go to jaspyshobbyland.com. Let's get it done. I know that the next full case of Immaculate Football is close to single digits. We can do that. I know there was some talk about Immaculate Baseball, half case random teams, second half of the case. We can do that. And I don't know. Oh, divisionals. We have got a second half of the case of random divisions for Immaculate Football. That could get knocked out as well. So go to jaspyshobbyland.com and get into it. Let's make it happen. All right, so there's Chris Archer, Class 1. David Price, 19 out of 50. That's a Class 2. For the Red Sox, going to Ethan. There's your there's Class 2, NL Rookie of the Year, Corey Seager. Third place in MVP voting. Second to last frame auto. There's Paul Goldschmidt. There's Matt Kemp, Padres edition. And we got Starling Marte, Pirates. Yarr. Pirates going out to John Parker. Arr. No? It's kind of a long break. There you go. Starling Marte. And the last box, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks very much for filling this up. It is actually nice to do a little baseball. We've done so much football that doing a little baseball and talking a little hot stove on a Thursday night, the 17th of November, was very, very nice. So thank you very much to all who filled up this break tonight. And I enjoy talking the baseball, so this was good. And after we're done with this break, we have, at least an hour and a half to go in the broadcast, which is plenty of time to knock out a couple more Immaculate breaks if you'd like, or whatever else we have on the website. So check it out, jaspyshobbyland.com. So Thanks for joining me. Appreciate it. Let's see what this last one has for us. There's Yaz, Carl Yastrzemski. That's a class one. And there's Noah Syndergaard. 22 out of 100, who had some funny responses to Kate Upton regarding the Cy Young Award. He's a good tweeter. That goes to the Mets, John Parker, with that one. There's Mike Trout, MVP for him, class two. Roberto Clemente, it's a class two. And the last autograph, the 16th auto, Gold Label Baseball. We're gonna get a gold frame auto. There's Mark McGwire. There's Nolan Ryan. And your last autograph is Peter O'Brien for the Diamondbacks. That's John Parker with the D-backs. Nice autograph right on the card. Gold frame, good looking stuff. Gold label, done. Thanks very much for joining me, Joe, on JaspysHobbyland.com. Like I said, we got a plenty of broadcast time left. So go to JaspysHobbyland.com. Let's fill up some more breaks. Let's do a couple more before we call it a night. Thanks very much, everyone. We'll see you next time.